So first, let us go through the circuit diagram for that. So since it is an R2R tag, so on the experiment is digital to analog converter. The input for this experiment is a digital input. So we are using 4 bits. So that is D0, D1, D2, and D3. So that is connected to an op amp. So you know that an op amp, it will convert analog signal input to a output. It can be amplified version of that. So here we are using 741 or OP47 op amp for converting the digital data from the non-inverting terminal. You please see here, we are connected to pin number 3 of the op amp, which is nothing but the non-inverting terminal. So that non-inverting terminal input is converted to output, and the corresponding analog output is obtained across pin number 6 based on the digits whatever we give, the digital inputs whatever we give. Okay. So now it is called as R to R, because so here whatever the R value we assume, so that is series resistance and 3 parallel resistance are there. So the series resistance we have taken as 1 kilo ohms, and the parallel resistance, it is double the series value, it is called as 2R. So hence the name R to 2R circuit. So now I will be explaining the design of this one, and then we will come to the calculation part of that. Okay. So let me explain the design of this one. So in that circuit, as you are seeing here, so I have assumed the resistance value, the series resistance value to be 1 kilo ohms. So therefore, 2R, it will be 2 into 1 kilo ohms, it will be 2 kilo ohms. But since we don't have the standard 2 kilo ohms, so we are taking that value to be 2.2 kilo ohms. 1 kilo ohms is available in the lab, whereas 2 kilo ohms is not available. So therefore, we are taking 2.2 kilo ohms. Okay, the output voltage across pin number 6 is given by this equation. So V0 is equal to V reference by 2 power n. So what is 2 power n represent is the number of bits what we are connecting. So here, as you can see, here 4 bits we are connecting. So therefore, I will take n is equal to 4. If I connect only 3 inputs, so it will be D0, D1, D2. So then it becomes 2 power 3. Okay. So in our experiment, we are connecting 4 inputs. So therefore, I am taking n to be 4. So times 2R divided by 2R plus R. Okay. So into. So this is what the value. So it is called as binary weighted resistance values we call. So it is the last bit is 2 power 3, so that is D0, so then 2 power 2 D2, so 2 power 1 D1 and 2 power 0 D0. Okay. So now I substitute here, so 2R by 2R plus R becomes 3R, R and R will get cancelled, it will become 2 by 3. So therefore I have written, so the final equation to be V0 is equal to 5. So what is this 5? This 5 represents the V reference. So that is V. V reference is 5. So 5 divided by 2 power 4 into 2 by 3 times 2 to the power of 3 D3, 2 power 2 D2, 2 power 1 D1 and 2 power 0 D0. Okay. So now if I substitute the digital values, if I substitute the digital values for say D0, D1, D2 and D3, and then using this simplify, I will get the analog input. So this is what the experiment is. So we are substituting the digital inputs in the form of zeros and ones, and we are getting the analog. Okay, so this is what the design part of this experiment. Okay, so now I will go to the tabular column of this experiment, and I will explain one by one. So here I have written the digital values, that is the D3, D2, D1 and D0, these are the digital values. So since it is n is equal to 4, so we get 2 power 4, it is 16. So therefore, we have got 16 combinations. So starting from 0, so up to 15, so it will be 16 combinations will be there. So now what I will do, I will substitute these values in that equation, V reference equation. First, if I substitute all zeros, so this will come up to 0 only. Now 5 by 16 into 2 by 3 times 2. So I will explain here. So you will substitute d naught is equal to 1. So all the other bits will be 0. So this will be 5 by 16. So into 2 by 3 times 2. So now if I simplify that, it will become 4 into 2. So the for the 1 bit, that is we call it as LSB, for 1 LSB change, we get the analog corresponding voltage as 0. So similarly, if I change the bit pattern, it will become 0.4. Similarly, for 3, it is 0.6. And we have calculated for all the values, the final values, that is, when all the bits are high, from LSB to MSB, all the bits are high, we get the output as 3. So this is what the theoretical value we call. Theoretical value we call. So now what we have to do? So we have to rig up this circuit. We have to rig up this circuit and we have to perform the experiment and we have to write the practical values. So naturally there will be some difference will be say. Then the difference we will see what much difference is there, we will note it down. Okay. So this is what the experiment is. We have to compare the theoretical and practical values. So this is what